Disjunctive group. A disjunctive group may be said to be one which does not allow a person to join similar other group at one and the same time. For example, college. If a person gets admission in a particular college, he will remain over there till his course is over. And after that, he may be allowed to join some other college. Number 17th is overlapping group. An overlapping group is one in which members can join as many groups as they like. 18th is genetic group. A genetic group is one which a person is born and required to join involuntarily. Means it is by birth. And congregate group. A congregate group may be said as one in which he moves voluntarily and joins or withdraws of his own. Then the social group. A social group is one which combines and mixes the other groups and helps other groups in social progress. The reference group. There are groups which are modeled to others. Reference group is one with which an individual compares and contrasts himself, his behavior, his goals, and his sentiments. The reference group is any group whose values and norms are ideal and are adopted by any individual who wants to improve his status. So, any ideal group, the group to which a person belongs, and the other group or other persons with whom he wants to compare himself and contrast himself, his behavior, his goals, and his sentiments is called a reference group. Reference groups have the following characteristics. Number one, the individual or group treats the behavior of another individual as ideal and imitates it. So, the other group or another individual is said to be an ideal of a, he treats him, that person or that group as an, as his ideal and tries to behave in according to that person or that group. The individual or group resorts to comparison between itself and the other individual or group. And the individual or a group tries to compare themselves with the ideal group. Third, an individual or group tries to attain a high scale by doing away with its defect or weakness. And whatever defects or weakness that particular group has, by observing the reference group, they try to overcome those defects and those weaknesses. The feeling or relative weakness in the individual or group leads to the feelings of relative deprivation in the individual or group. Man goes after models. One wants to follow those whom one observes progressing. So only those models or those groups are followed which a person thinks are progressive. Social and economic standard and psychological level of the individual or group is generally accepted. So, social and economic standards and the psychological level of the members of the group are to be considered before accepting the group as the reference group behavior. Members of lesser social strata try to follow the cultural levels of high strata. So also weaker minds are influenced by stronger ones. Reference groups are of two types. Number one, positive reference group. Positive reference groups are those the membership of which is eagerly sought by the individuals, like for example occupational groups, athletic groups, theatrical groups, the circuses, upper classes. Second is the negative reference group. Negative reference groups are those whose ways or wants are to be avoided. Upper strata groups looks at lower strata group as negative reference group. So positive reference groups are those groups where the membership of which is eagerly sought by the individuals. Every person wants to become a member of the positive reference group. A negative reference group is where the person tries to avoid the membership of a particular individual or a particular group. The reference group behavior theory explains the behaviors only, but does not envisage any means to control it. In reference group behavior theory, there is nothing has been mentioned regarding the control of the behavior of the members, but it says that who want to it says how the members can be influenced to join its membership. It explains how an individual is influenced by reference group, but fails to explain how the reference group is affected by the entry of the individual. The last type of group is your peer group. Groups of people of similar status are called peer groups. For example, classmates form as peer groups. Most close friendship is formed between members of peer groups because they have much in common and can share experiences as equals. So is the example of peer group is your classmates. Children have, in a same class, have same common goals, they have same syllabus, they have same interests, everything is same, everything is similar. So each and every member of the class wants to experience wants to share the experiences with the others inside the group and treat themselves as equals. Friendship develops between children of the same class at school or between workers of the same rank at office or factory. Peer groups often form on the basis of similarities between people and also because they come together by participating in similar activities. Often peers meet and see each other regularly because they are in the same class at school or the same scouting group, or because they live in the same block, or because they work side by side in the assembly.